my mom, she was a booster like my whole life, like when I was younger and shit like that. I've been rocking Dior. That's why I love Dior so much. She used to keep me like in Dior and Taylor, like shit that, you know, like a lot of these girls right now don't know about. They're not up on. Like I used to wear suits to school, like in elementary. I used to be in suits with blazers and shit like that. I used to be Janet Jackson for Halloween with the earring, with the shoulder pads, with the whole nine, like the weave ponytail. Like my mom used to really like dress me up and put me into character, me and my brother. So we are used to like dressing, and if I can't do it, I'm uncomfortable, like I don't feel like myself. So, you know, I began boosting too. Shit, when, you know, I got older, it's just like, oh, you gotta learn something for yourself. And it's funny what you pick up on, like the whole time they thought we wasn't watching. Shit, I been knew how to scam. I been knew what they was doing. Like, I'm right here. I seen it, I learned it, I mastered it, and I was fly every day of my life. I went to Paris for my birthday. I had met a cool dude, Ian, and he wanted me to be the face of his female line or whatever, sicko. So I had met Ian, and we went to Paris. Basically, it was my birthday, and it was Fashion Week. So he was like, yo, I want you to come with me to Paris Fashion Week, and I'm gonna work out there, and there's people out there, all that shit. So I wound up going out there. I ran into Rihanna, like, I was like, damn, like, you know what I'm saying? I ain't wanna let him know or nobody know. But she hollered out my name. She was like, Tommie, in her little voice. So I'm like,
motherfucker, wait, it's that bitch.
No, she was just so cool and laid back. She was like, rooting for you, like, you got this. I just started like really peeping like what she into, what she do. And just the way that she like was down earth and shit like that, it made me want to know more. So her diamond ball was coming. It's for a children's school in Barbados. It's the Clara Richard Foundation or whatever. And say my money was going to a school that's named after her grandmother in Barbados. I started my own motherfucking foundation. I went to Miami, KD. I'm like, Katie, I want to start a foundation. I'm going to put it in my grandmother's name. And I wanted to be a teen shelter. So I started up the Helen Ross Foundation, and I'm gonna do a ball too. It's gonna be called the Reality Ball. I asked a friend, how can I get in that diamond ball? So she like, oh, I could get you ticked like it was nothing.
And this smart ass back. You're in a lot of fucking pressure. Gotta be in fucking court 8 a.m. and 7. Gotta be in New York right at.
Yo, Mari got the job. What the fuck do we do now? Oh my god.
Wow.
This is crazy. Oh my god. Mari got the fucking job. My fucking kid works at McDonald's. I'm gonna go get her fire. I swear to god. Oh my god. What the fuck? I never expected her to get the job. I didn't even like help her. Like I was like, I'm not even gonna tell her what to say and what not to say. Oh, hello. I'm pulling up right now. 5 minutes. So now we gotta call somebody else who knows how to negotiate. Yeah, I'm coming out. I'm a. All right. You know what? Where he at? Where you driving at?
Don't film.
Yeah,
so. Do you want to go to Time, New York?
The address is.
Why would you even come here? Why would you just go there? That make no sense. Why you ain't tell me that over the phone? Like,
224.
I had to go to court that morning, bang, go to New York. Then when I get to New York for the diamond ball, my stylist that I sent out there to get, he ain't got no dress. And so
like at the last minute, we like seconds on the clock, a box come to my door. It's like from Virgil's Off-White. It's from the Off-White people, all them, you know, and it's like two bomb ass dresses. And I'm like, okay, I forgive him. He my friend again.
Crazy crack.
Hello?
I'm over here doing all these
niggas dreams. Hold on. Find
out your dick,
yeah.
Yeah,
I need help for 2 seconds.
In. My phone's down too.
The zipper goes on the side because one side is longer because of the sleeve.
Like
in the closet, zipping up.
But where those shades at? Just
look
after, like, I was swimming. Where are they?
Let me see.
Where those shades?
I get them. Let me see that for
real,
please.
Do they,
you
are they out here?
No. Can I get some long as well?
Yeah.
Yo, bro, do you see this fucking
thing? Where is it now? What?
It's him.
No. It's fine. Yo, you order one, bro. Order one, bro. You actually have Uber. Order it, bro.
Oh, my.
Come on. Order the luxury.
Nah,
I
know, bro. It's fine. Yeah, I'm about to come in, man. I'm about to.
This is crazy.
Go in to Mark.
Like, what the fuck? This is a fucking bunch of no. They're not doing fucking shit right. Nothing.
Ridiculous. I want to see those fucking shades, like, maybe 5 years. It's crazy. Let me see them shades. Let me see them shades, right quick. I need to do that. You know, my damn shades. We get outside. It's like a van out there. This man's so ready to throw us in a van. I'm like, oh, man, these boys play too much. Because he'll get in anything. I can't run myself like that. I got to have a black car, a black truck. What is wrong with you? So, oh God, let me go to the bar. And like, when you go to the bar, I grew up like in a bar too, like at the school in Jersey. My mama sent me with my auntie and she owned a bar. And I just sit in there and watch them folks talk, drink, all of that stuff. Like, it was like Cheers. So I always go to the bar. Let me get a glass of Chardonnay. I don't drink hard liquor like that, but I do love wine. And the man just telling me, he like, what's wrong? I'm like, I'm a little nervous, red carpet. All of that, he like, well, if they don't like you, then why would you be worried about what other people think? Fuck them. And that's the prime example, like bar talk. When you go to the bar, you're going to meet somebody who don't give a fuck and who going to say something that makes sense, like drunk or sober, like.
See you later, guys.
Bye.
Bye. How do my booty look at this? Who what? Yeah, Tommie and Paul. This is my nigga Paris, and y'all already know how we reppin'. Y'all the motherfuckers on the wall, bitch. Come through, drippin'.
Drippin' and the pink ballerina.
Pink ballerina. Whole lot of
shit going on. You're so gorgeous.
That's hot. Going back to Jersey, going back to North, the bridge where I'm from, I gotta stop at Grilled Chicken. Every time I go home, I go to my grandma. She got the same house, same porch, same place I grew up in, same backyard where I had the parties. Everything is like the same.
Yeah, y'all, so just like my, this is my old house or whatever where we grew up. This my house, Mr. Frank, Miss Artie. This house? Was not right here. This is my, you got your flash, I guess? Yeah. They just put this house right here, but all of this was our yard. And we had a swing set and all of that, like a tree house back there. Damn, this shit looks so different. That's crazy. And that's the cemetery over there.
Oh,
where
yeah.
We used to play high and go seek and jump rope and shit, like down the street, and we used to play football. Like all the boys go over there and play football. It was none of these weeds and shit. They actually care. But everybody over there, like, so. This is on the cemetery, too, all of these houses. So this side was the cemetery, too, but they just paved over it. Flew up in the air, like, I don't know. It was like 15 feet. Flew up in the air. Bomb hit the ground. My neck was twisted. Somebody just came through here speeding because this is a one-way or whatever. But, yeah.
And it just felt like home. Like, you know, like nothing really changed. Like, it's... Well, the cemetery is, you know, certain little things bring back little bad memories and stuff like that. A lot of people that I know are not here anymore.
Yeah.
Were you scared growing up across the street from the cemetery?
No, it was like normal. Like it was.
I was scared too.
Yeah. It was normal. I used to scare my friends. I used to take them over there because it's like the Kruegers is over there. They got Freddy Krueger, Patricia Krueger, all of that. So I used to bring them over there. The bitches never wanted to come back. Like she's crazy.
Right. Going back there is always like, you know, my uncle going answer the door with a knife or, you know what I'm saying, some gun or some shit. A bag. He get real creative and then go like, "Who is it?" Cause I always come late. Oh, it's why you never come over. And a decent, you know what I mean? Like you always come late, but they don't never like try to make me feel bad because they just accept me when I come. Whenever I come, I'm just traffic.
Keep it low, nigga. Run down on you. Yeah, with your P's and Q's out this motherfucker. Motherfucker just got killed out here last night.
Where?
I just be passing through whatever. Whenever I could get there and they accept me, come sit on the porch with me, whether it's 1, 2, 3 in the morning. My grandma gonna come sit on the stoop with me and we gonna chop it up. She gonna be like, how that show? Like, that's like the highlight of my life, like going back to what I know and what is real. And that's how I feel when I go to North. I just feel real. Like,
he always pumped me up, youngster. He'd be like, that shit gonna go. That shit gonna go, bro. I'm telling you. He'd be like, so what's your mood? I guess I was like too calm one night in the club. He'd like, man, show me your moves. And I'm like, what? He'd be like, show me what you be doing. Shot it originally, it was in Miami. It was a flop because so many of my niggas, I took them to the hood that I be in, Miami Robin Hood, and so many of my niggas came out there with guns and choppers, all of that. And so of course naturally the hood nigga gonna be uncomfortable, even though you bout that street shit. I could feel he was uncomfortable because he only gave the video 15 minutes and then he was like, all right, Tommy, I gotta go. The final youngster video, it didn't come out exactly how we wanted it because like that day had been so much like pressure.
Did you see that that it was actually Arby King here?
Yeah, I met her.
What were you talking about? Like the mom, like Arby King, besides my house, his mama come out there with the weary face, like what the fuck? And there's a whole host in the side. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, sure.
We start arguing and going through the whole motions, and there's a bitch out there behind the door. And some ratchet shit. I don't know what you have planned, but I'm just trying to think
with you. No, I'm honestly open to any like creative ideas you have. I'm incorporating them and making them adjustments.
Mm-hmm. We can't
do your job.
We can't.
From him. I had drop, so what you gonna do if I get exactly? I'm gonna
tell you to get one. Me, no. Him, can't. Also,
my
driver. So you gonna cancel the job? You
gonna cancel the job? Oh my god, you have a whole car.
Do it. I can fit in this small ass car.
You know, how can't you fit?
I cannot fit in that car with my people and myself.
Who's your people? And yourself, you have kids.
I have him also now too, and I also have the fucking right. Lady. Stop playing games.
No, bro. No, I don't care. I take my
car. I said I'm we'll see you in the car. Like, what the
child is because child.
We had a big ass argument and like he just kept fucking with me the whole day. I don't know whether he was jealous. I don't know what was wrong with him, but he kept fucking with me. So that shit was kind of all over the place. That made me drink a lot because I was aggravated. And so by the time I'm drunk, it's done, bitch. I'm wavy in that bitch.
She drunk. She
got
too much.
They gave her a towel. Okay, wait.
Ian, stop.
Hey, stop. Y'all stop. Stop for real. Stop. No, don't. Stop. Lay down.
It be so many shits going on behind the scenes. Me and Youngster have not been able to be in the same place. I am going to get something done here today. I don't give a fuck what's going on. Nigga, I don't care. Like, I am going to get this completed. These people are waiting on this. Being independent. Being an independent artist. Boy, oh my God. Like, it's some shit.
Look how many people it takes to tame her.
Excuse me?
Pierre, and he's like the CEO of QC. It's like the biggest record label in Atlanta, biggest record label right now. And he's always like, he wanted to sign me and shit like that. He used to always tell me, like, you a star. You a star. You just gotta stop drinking. He hated that I drunk and all that shit like that. A lot of the reasons why I was drinking, he didn't know him, but you know what I'm saying? That was just like a comfort place. It got me in a world of trouble. And he was just like, man, I was happy. He was like, I don't want to see you in jail, but I was happy you did. I started crying. I was like, bro, man, I was at peace, man. I ain't had to worry about this or that. And I, like, you know, I could tune back into myself. I read so many books. I was just like, I just felt so good when I got out. Bang. Like a couple of days later, Juan got killed. I said I wasn't gonna drink no more. I'm like, man, I love the way I feel. I love the way I feel. I just gotta lose this weight. Why I got killed? I'm just like, man, I need a drink.
I tell her hop on.
I really need.
She said she wanna ride.
It's kind of just been like my outlet. Like,
I tell her, man,
when I was in jail, you know, a lot of phone calls got me through. Was to my daughter, and then, you know, Juan. Like, I talked to him the whole while I was in jail, and I had a dream that he got killed. Yep, I had a dream that he got killed back in October. And I had hit him because we wasn't talking before I went in.
So get out my video.
If
I'm who, you get out.
I'm in Cali.
Look at my video too.
And when I had a dream, he was like, I'm going home tomorrow. And he went home, and when I got transferred to Rice Street, we still was talking, and we was talking about, you know, being back. When I get out, I better come straight to him. He's like, what you gonna do? When you get out, you gonna be different? Or you gonna be on the same shit? Man, I wanna see you boss up on these motherfuckers. I wanna see you this and that. What you doing? Like, he'll put, like, all this money in my books, everything. Like, he got me through. Like, I ain't gonna lie. And when I got out, I was, like, highly disappointed and hurt. Like, what happened? How it happened? Yo. That shit fucked me up. And, you know, everybody on social media, they like, ain't she supposed to be with a boy? And ain't she supposed to this? Man, I didn't give a fuck about none of that. Some people might say, like, I was insensitive to what I had going on and other people's feelings. But, like, Wine and me have been friends for, like, 5 years. And it's, like, not even about losing, like, an ex. It's, like, I lost my friend, like, one of my closest friends. And it's just, like, that shit hurt. So, you know, and if things was right with me and him, it would be no other people at that moment. So I really didn't care if they understood or not.
Like, you be around my family all the time. Right. You're here. What do you think about this?
This is, like, so long.
Do you put record clothes in here? Just, like,
yeah.
Clothes.
Okay.
No, anything. I'm just like, I don't even know where to start. Like, it's embarrassing. It's hurtful. It's everything. It's like every emotion I could possibly, like,
feel.
Overwhelmed, like, everything, man. I don't even know how to come back to to be honest. I'm like, I ain't coming back until such and such weeks, and I got work to do, but I don't even know how the fuck to come back because it's just like so embarrassing and so not true. Like, mm-hmm. But with all the shit that I done already done, it's like, who gonna believe me? That's what comes, that's what it boils down to, people. When you do so much shit don't matter, you know what I'm saying? The reason, the cause you get caught up in so much shit, like, your word is kind of like nothing, you know what I'm saying? My mother found out, my mother's in fucking, you know, she went to court in Vegas and she got 3 years. My mother's gone for 3 years, bro. Yeah, all of that shit is just like, God forbid, you know what I'm saying? Man, it's just like everything upside down, but you know, I'm hopeful. I ain't even really had time to reflect on my year, like, until I got in there. Like, I went through a terrible year and I didn't even notice it because I was like so high on my high atus. It was just like, anything that happened, bomb, fuck that. Oh, okay, let's. It's new day, you know what I'm saying? I wasn't never taking time to like reflect and really like, yo, a lot of have I lost the eyelid around this motherfucker? What? Nah, that shit was like a bad. I got bit by a dog.
Oh yeah,
remember that? I got all this shit happened this year. Bit by a dog in the studio. Lost the love of my life. Twice, got them back, lost them again. Just a lot of shit. Went to jail like 6 times this year. 6 times. I ain't never been to jail that many times in 1 year in my life. It's crazy.
Do I believe in child abuse? No. No way. I'm against that. I don't like when people hurt children. That break me down, hurt me to my soul.
When I caught the child abuse charge, I was like, man, you know, that broke me down. That really hurt me. I made it my business. Like, my kids are never gonna go to jail. I wanna, whatever I've done in the past, I did that so they won't have to do it. I don't wanna see my kids go through what I went through in life. I will lay down and die so they don't have to go through that. And then here I am faced with this, and I know it's a mistake, but our children's lives are so fragile to America. Like, it really does eat us young. Like, you don't have no room for mistakes. One mistake could cost you your whole life. And I was just so scared. So I made it a point to explain to her. I'm like, Havali, you can't get in any trouble. Havali is going through whatever in school, trying to be like, you know, cool or whatever. She's at a new school. She's being goofy. She's acting out in class. It's like the teacher called me twice. And she's starting to fail academically, and she's never failed. She's always been on the honor roll. My child's been on the honor roll her whole life. So it's just like, what is going on? When I'm talking to her, it's when I'm home for a couple of days or hours, but then I'm always gone because I'm always working. And because I'm a single parent, you know what I'm saying? I can't really like say, hey, I quit. I want to just be a mom full time. I wish I had that option, that luxury, but I don't. And so, like, you know, I get another call. This is the third call. The teacher's like, Havali, it's really disrespecting me in front of the class. She's being a class clown. She's interrupting the class. She's all of these things. And I'm like, whoa, wait. She disrespected you? I felt really, really bad for her. And I'm like, why is Havali now doing this? And she know what we up against. The whole situation was just like scary. It was just so scary because I just don't want to see my child in juvenile, in jail. I don't want to see her end up with the same fate as mine. I've never ever had a defects case. I've never had anybody have to come in. I never pushed my kids off on nobody. Like, I've always done all of these things to provide for them. Like, I don't glamorize the things that I had to do or I was doing or, you know, but I did it for 2 other lives. Like, I did it for my kids. And due to everything that's going on, like, VH1 don't want to move with me until the case is dismissed. So guess what? I got to get back out here, start all over, hustle all over. I may lose my house. I may have to, you know, relocate my children. Man, come on. It got to come a time where, like, y'all got to feel me. Y'all got to understand some of this now.
I know I'm not a perfect person, but we don't deserve all of this either.
From like all of my life, my mom has always been there. Like she's never left us, and she has seven kids. She has seven kids, but no matter, she moved to Georgia, wherever she took us with us, and she tried her best being a single mom. So I learned a lot from my mother because she did it on her own majority of the time. And like, you know, I just always will love her to the end of time because she never left us. You know, we always don't get along. Like me and my mom go through it. We don't always get along. And all I could just remember is that like she could have left me and she could have just said, you know, fuck me, but she didn't. So like, no matter how much we don't get along, I never, ever, ever forget that she kept me and she loved me. So. I am supposed to be in like a whole nother side of the earth, like a whole nother country, and all I could just think about is like, if I'm over here and something happened to my mom, yo, what the fuck? You get what I'm saying? Like, how am I be able to live with myself and I, if I never get the opportunity to make her like proud? Like, and that's what I'm saying. I'm like, I was the first child, you could have stopped at me, like, and then you had six more kids, and like, I raised those kids, like, it wasn't no nannies or babies. It was me. And like, how could you forget that? Like, you know what I mean? How could you forget all of those things? Like, I was in a shelter with you. Like, I basically grew up with you. All of your sufferings that you feel like you went through alone, I went through them with you. You know what I mean? So why now would I be in a situation to change both of our lives and not do it? Like, you know what I mean? Obviously, it's a reason why I haven't brought you like, it's the reason, like, I'm not there yet, and I just wish that she could understand that. I basically just want the young girls that look up to me, and you know, young girls, guys, whoever looking up to me, to understand that like what I went through, I don't glamorize that. And I know that it's a lot of y'all going through way more shit than me or the same thing. And I just want to be an example so that you see that you can make it out. Like, and there's another way. Like, you don't ever think that you have to give up. Like, I'm watching so many people like commit suicide and in their whole life because of a bad day, a bad week, a bad year. I had a terrible year last year, but you know what? I'm determined to have a better year this year and going forward in my future. Like, I'm not gonna let it stop me. I'm a mother, I'm a mom. I love my kids more than life. And like, I have to keep going for them. So, that's, you know, this shit, like, when you talented, like, it don't matter. It's gonna be some type of struggle for you to appreciate it. And this is my struggle today, and it's been my struggle, seem like, all week since I've been home in Atlanta, is to get in the studio. I don't wanna be your baby mama, bitch. Do that pussy on him. He bought me your conscience. I remember like praying to God. I used to say, God, please, can you please just, if you help me to change my life. Like, you know, I dropped out of school. I don't have much background for work. I just please, Lord, I don't want to steal no more. I don't want to do this no more. Like, please, if you give me a chance, I will promise you I will change my life around. And that's like a promise that I made to God. Like, always, even when I was going to go do something wrong to make money, I'll be praying. I'll be praying the whole way in there. I'll be praying the whole way out. I'll be celebrating in prayer. Like, I never, you know, turn my back on God. I just knew that, you know, my time was coming.
I always used to say, man, I ain't even gonna say, I was going to jail so much, I'm not even about to say, like, or I ain't going to jail again, because I'm like, that's gonna jinx me. I'll probably go back the next day after I say that, so I ain't even saying that. But something about me going to jail this time and turning myself in for the 2 days they gave me with my probation for my 3-year-old DUI, had to get clowned and drugged by that Tommie Lee is in jail again. Little do they know, this is like for 4 years old. It feel like when you trying to do something right, everything in its power in the past come back to you, like, try to knock you down.
Nah, nigga. Don't make me no promises. If you don't give it up, then I'm taking shit. Tommie.
Truth was needed for me, and it was needed for my fans and the non-fans as well. It was needed for all parties, because like a lot of people seen like just different clips and bullshit of me that I was going through. I was getting locked up left and right. Like, you know what I mean? It's just like, what is wrong with this girl? Like, she's been given a chance, and why is she not taking it serious? And this and this and that. And it's just like, listen, let me explain something to you motherfuckers. I'm very serious about what's going on in my life. And I'm also a target. I'm a target. Like, I didn't live, you know, like a snooty bitch my whole life. Like, I had to get in. I've been jumped off the porch. I've been, you know, in the streets. Like, for real in the streets. I've been having to fend for myself. And basically, you know, that caused me to get into a lot of trouble. It's no different if you put me on TV and you put me in a situation. Like, it's just street shit. It's just the way I've been taught. It's just like a defense mechanism. It was, you know what I mean? Now I'm learning like a different way. Like, I'm gonna have to shoot some of these bitches like now. I'm just like, yeah, I've been doing yoga. What?
You done made it, baby.
You done made it.
So Chico, I met Chico one in Miami, Meek Mill. Every time I went around Chico, it was like a memorable time. It was like the time of my life.
She still fuck with me, in and out of custody. Slick niggas lust to me, promises shit. On top of that, dealing with the fact my mama's sick. Fatal illness, you don't know the type of shit I deal with. Say I'm an alcoholic, so what, I take a sip? I'm just trying to cope with some real shit. Paint me out to be the villain. But if I hand you my lubricants, bet your feet can't fit in. Before VH1 on Mondays, or front rows on runways. Knew I would get it one way, legit, where your gun play. Can I be honest? This ain't edited for a sketch. Still that girl my uncle used to molest. Still that girl my mama used to neglect. So I grew up fast and knew how to finesse. I digress. See, they know the old Tommie. But I smart.
I'm probably like the first person in my family, like my immediate family right here, like to see this type of money. And it's not even done, like I'm not even finished, but like I definitely have a duty to make sure that I'm not the last. Like, I gotta share the wealth, I gotta share this with my family. Yeah. And that's what I'm doing right now. I'm just trying to make a way that we all can eat. Like, not just me, or like everybody sitting at the table, got a job, got a hustle, got to get my brothers out the streets, get my sister out the streets. Like, I want all of us to win and succeed. Like, that's my job now, to make sure that they got jobs.
Today's the last day that I'm going to go to jail and never be incarcerated. So today is actually should be celebrated. I never said this before because I always knew I was going back to jail. So I never wanted to jinx myself by saying that I'm never coming back. So I never said that. So today I want to see how I feel to say that and make that possible. I have until 9 o'clock to go turn myself in. And it is, what time is it, AJ?
8:11.
It's 8:11?
Yeah.
Oh my God. All right, so come on. Maybe some blush for my mugshot.